we think about the realities of the NHL in 2018, player movement is part of it. These were two massive moves, seismic shifts. Watts, Weeksy, when you look back at that, what comes to mind?
For me, the John Tavares one really comes to mind. It was the end of an era for New York Islanders fans, an era that, quite frankly, began in 2009 at the draft. When John Tavares was selected first overall, there was such great hype, and he would go on and play tremendous for the New York Islanders. But in the end, Weeksy, it was all about coming home. And nobody knows more about Toronto than you do.
And clearly in him as well, for being a product of the GTHL youth hockey in Toronto. For him, it was unique timing. As you heard him talk about the timing, everything just felt right. And that was a real influence in his decision. And I spoke to a lot of people in his camp leading up to this decision. And I kept pounding the phones. I don't think I have any fingerprints left. What's happening? What's happening? Speaking to his representatives. What's happening? Where is he going? Weeksy, we don't know. Where is he going? Weeksy, we don't know. But what I did know is that I felt like it was unlikely. I just had that inkling it was unlikely that he was going to return to Long Island for the Islanders, which was to the dismay of the Isles fans. But as you said, it's a new era for them. Yep. But for the Toronto Maple Leafs, and specifically for Tavares, the opportunity to return to play for his hometown favorite team as an NHLer, as an established star, was something he felt he couldn't pass up.
He slept on the sheets. We had that in the pack. That was amazing. Who could begrudge him that? And who could begrudge Sharks fans the thrill that they got? Erik Karlsson, you had a Norris winner. Now you have multiple Norris winners, and your GM's a Norris winner. No wonder they were so fired up to get EK65.
Well, of course they were, because he was the big fish that was out there in the trade market. It wasn't an unrestricted free agent, of course. Doesn't matter. Just as big for the San Jose Sharks. Erik Karlsson had run his course in Ottawa. He knew he was going to get traded. It was just a matter of time. There wasn't really that many suitors. There was a very narrow group, but at the end, no surprise to me, Doug Wilson is the guy that came out on top. The San Jose Sharks organization, much better off for it. And Erik Karlsson on his way to California, and he looks good there.
Yeah, and who could blame them? I mean, you want to go out and you want to make not just a statement, you want to make your best effort to get the best player, the best asset for your team. And Tone, you just pointed it out. This San Jose Sharks team, yeah, we've got a GM, that's a Norris. We've got Brent Burns, and Burns used now 600-point club. That's a Norris Trophy winner on defense. And you go out and get two-time Norris Trophy winner in Erik Karlsson. So you've got to go out and make the moves that give yourself a chance and your team a chance. And I have to say this, Doug Wilson and Mr. Plattner out there in San Jose have done an amazing job retaining their players, taking care of their players and their staff, and also making big deals as well as subtle deals. They've been one of the most consistent franchises in the National Hockey League. This was a huge play for them.